us a glimpse of his new aggressiveness, and then making Daniel Bryan tap out here to Bryan's own finishing maneuver, the lapel lock. Sin Cara has put SmackDown on notice, and I, for one, love Sin Cara's actions.
And it's coming from Aberdeen, Washington, weighing 192 pounds, Daniel Bryan.
And Booker, the point I want to make is this. Come Sunday at Night of Champions, if Triple H loses to CM Punk, there's going to be a new COO of this company. That means it's an opportunity for the likes of Sin Cara and Daniel Bryan, a lot of the young superstars here in WWE, to step up. This is an important moment for guys like Sin Cara.
You know, I agree with you on that, Cody. It's all about stepping up here in the WWE. These two men right here have a huge share, both in my Fave Five, just to let you know about that.
Booker, you actually last week supported this darker side of Sin Cara.
You know, I really did. I like Sin Cara. I like the attitude. Coming out here, it's all about
a
fight.
Hey, guys, look at this. You're right, there's a fight going on.
That's what D. Bryan needs to get in his mind, man. Come out here and just put a whooping on somebody like he's doing right now.
Yeah, but I blame a lot of this for Sin Cara. Sin Cara has, well, he lit the fuse under Daniel Bryan, much like Cody Rhodes lit the fuse under Ted DiBiase moments ago. And that's what I'm talking about, guys. Superstars are jockeying for position here on SmackDown and Monday Night on Raw. It is a huge time.
Did you see that? Right there, D. Bryan just scouted that boy. D. Bryan is totally on top of his game, and right now, Oh my goodness.
But what about the quickness of Sin Cara there?
I'm totally impressed with Sin Cara. I mean, Sin Cara has all the goods. I told you, this guy has a mean streak. He has a lot of fight in. I like that. Check this out right here. D. Bryan was going for that puncher, that suicide dive, but Sin Cara caught him on the rebound.
But that mean streak is good, though, for the likes of Sin Cara.
Definitely, I think the mean streak is good. Sin Cara is looking, like I said before, to make a play here on SmackDown, and he's doing a hell of a job.
You guys get my point. I mean, Raw is a super show each and every week. All these superstars here on SmackDown and on Raw jockeying for position. This is a huge time. There's a change in the landscape of WWE right now, and all these young superstars are jockeying to be at the top of that pecking order.
Yeah, but you can almost feel the changing here in WWE. A lot of intensity. We saw it from Ted DiBiase earlier. You're seeing it here from both Sin Cara and Daniel Bryan, who crashes down.
I like the Sin Cara.
Hip bones connected to the leg bone.
What?
We welcome you back to Friday Night SmackDown. It's been an explosive night thus far, as Sin Cara is in control here of Daniel Bryan. Booker, Sin Cara really took over before the commercial break.
I'll tell you something, Sin Cara is like totally a man on a mission. Check this out right here, right there. That's what I'm talking about. Hip bone connected to the leg bone. Right there, D. Bryan fell right on that hip. He's going to have a lot of trouble from that, dog.
Well, the hip bone used to be connected to the leg bone.
Booker, a new wrinkle in the offensive. Sin Cara here with this submission hold.
I wouldn't necessarily say that. Sin Cara, like I say, Sin Cara can go up top. The guy can get his technical ground game. Totally sound. On the other hand, my boy D. Bryan, totally sound in all those departments. Awesome.
We saw Sin Cara use Daniel Bryan's own lapel lock against him last week, so Sin Cara does know what he's doing when it comes to submission maneuvers.
Well, look in the eyes there of Daniel Bryan. Bryan almost looking to regain his composure here.
Oh, look at the eyes of Sin Cara, though.
How can you see his eyes? He's wearing a mask.
Sin Cara.
That belongs on the new .com show. What the?
Oh, check it out.
Whoa, flat headbutt by Sin Cara. This could
Cara
be it.
Hooks the outside leg of Daniel Bryan. Whoa. Powers out.
Next, you're going to tell me the expression on Sin Cara's face tells the story. You know what, Booker? We just need to sit good old JR down next to you, and we'd be all set out here. One guy
about?
Who can't speak,
like
the
JR.
Other guy who can't speak.
I like JR. He's a good friend of mine.
Oh, I'm sure he is. That's right. He bought you a drink when I was born. Then talk behind your back for
Did
an hour afterwards.
You see that right there? See, Carl was going for the coup d'etat. D. Bryan right on the money right there.
And, Cole, you really believe in superstars having this attitude about themselves where they don't need anyone else, but they can do it on their own.
Josh, check this out right here. Ooh, wow. I'm telling you, I thought he caught it to the rib right there, but D. Bryan caught that boy right to the mush.
I forgot your question because Booker was rambling on.
Ow! Sin Cara looking to build some speed and momentum.
Oh, wow.
Up there by Daniel Bryan.
But what about the viciousness now out of Daniel Bryan here tonight? These two guys kicking it up a notch.
Look,
that
you.
May have been the knockout kick by Daniel Bryan. Right, inside leg is hooked, and Sincara barely escapes.
Let me tell you something. There's a fight going down tonight on Friday Night SmackDown, and I'm loving every bit of it.
You know, I get all over Daniel Bryan about being a nerd and the like, but I'll tell you, he's showing something here tonight.
Oh, I'll tell it again, Cole.
Daniel Bryan showing something
here
tonight.
There he goes. The submission expert, Daniel Bryan.
I think he might have had a piece of steak before the match. He's a vegan. Get it?
Let me check this out right here. This is a high-risk maneuver. Sincara. I'm going to tell you, both of these guys right here are leaving it in the middle of this ring. This is a feud right here. This thing here can last for a long time.
Sincara is so clever. And we call them rivalries.
Daniel Bryan in a bad way right now. Just all opened up for Sincara.
He's got a five count on his letter.
Three, four, five.
He's kicking him in the head. Armstrong had no choice but to call for a bell.
The winner of this match is the result of a disqualification, Daniel Bryan.
Well, the rules clearly state that if your opponent's tied up in the ropes, you have 5 seconds to break whatever you're doing.
Man, this thing was getting hot. I didn't want to see it ending like that.
Oh man, right to the skull. Did you see Daniel Bryan's neck and the way it snapped?
Right there is the real Sincara, Cole.
Which one?
That one.
I don't get it.
Claims to have all the answers around here.
Oh, but I didn't say I could read the expression through the mask. Booker did. Booker, come on. Who's the real Sincara?
You know, I really think the guy in the middle of the ring right there, Sincara, I think that's the real Sincara.
Why would you say that?
I noticed something on his boots. He got a little black mark on his boots that I've been noticing for the last few weeks. I think that's the real one.
Well, we can all agree that there is only one world's strongest man, Mark Henry, whose path of destruction has been well documented. It continued a couple of weeks ago on a very vulnerable Randy Orton, who just finished a steel cage match with Christian.
Mark Henry, the number one contender, assaulting Orton. Whoa.
Orton off the steel cage.
Dangerous man of the WWE, Mark Henry.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Mark Henry will join the World Heavyweight Champion Randy Orton in the Cutting Edge tonight. Edge is back, and so is his controversial talk show. It happens tonight on SmackDown.
Come on, Teddy, do you really think that Mark Henry and Randy Orton can stand in the same ring for the Cutting Edge without manhandling each other? I mean, come on, bro. I mean, last week, Mark, he laid me out. I didn't even do anything for no reason.
Well, I'm gonna tell you something right now, Zach. The both of them are going to act like professionals. Because once again, I'm going to invoke a no contact rule. Now, what that means, if Orton or Henry engage in any physicality during the Cutting Edge, then the match this Sunday is off. Okay. You got that?
Yeah.
Well, I want you to relay it to both of them.
Yeah, I'll pass it along.
Leia, woo woo woo, don't blow it. That's Sonny.
I love it when you send people to get home.
It's not exactly like that, Oksana. I just want Zach to take responsibility.
In my country, I have responsibility to give man who works hard daily massage. Would you like a massage?
All right, maybe a quick one.
Let me see your back, baby.
Yes.
Feels so tight.
That feels really good, Oksana. Really good.
Bend over. Let me see your lower back.
Okay.
Oh, Teddy, you're really tight.
Yes.
Does it feel better?
Oh, yes, right there. Oh, Oksana. Right there.
Hi. It was just a flash, yeah. No. Hi.
Trish Stratus.
Hello.
Listen now, it's not what you think, all right?
Yeah, no, it never is. Probably just had something tight back there.
No, I'm not tight. this is really awkward.
Sure is. So I'm gonna go now. So I'll see you after.
This is a Divas Bout Super One Fall. Currently in the ring from Union City, New Jersey, AJ!
The spunky, self-professed geek goddess, AJ, with her best friend, Caitlin, all set for action here tonight.
Spunky
geek goddess.
And her opponent being accompanied to the ring by Natalia, from Buffalo, New York, the Amazon Beth Phoenix.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard Beth Phoenix being introduced from her hometown of Buffalo, New York, and that's where we will be. Sunday night for Night of Champions, the one night of the year that all WWE titles will be defended, including Kelly's Divas Championship when she puts it on the line against Beth Phoenix and Booker. I hate to say it, but I think Kelly's amazing Divas Championship reign is over tonight.
To tell you something, I actually seen Beth Phoenix in the gym pushing 225 pounds on the bench. Cole, you can't push 225 pounds on the bench. Beth Phoenix is ready to do work.
A little bit of where's that? Trepidation
exactly.
On the face of AJ, who was a part of NXT Season 3. That was won by AJ's best friend, Caitlin. Beth just now intimidating AJ.
Just one man handle AJ.
What did you just say?
Woman handled. You get it?
You're not even saying it right. You're saying handled. It's handled.
And there, that's the sheer power.
You said man handled. It's handled.
Amazon,
Beth Phoenix. Kelly, I hope she's watching.
It's almost like a tune-up match right here. AJ's about the same size as Kelly. Right now,
wow.
I see Beth Phoenix just doing it like it's supposed to be done.
Again, the power on display of Beth Phoenix. AJ and Kelly Booker, they may be the same size, but Kelly's a lot more accomplished at this point in her career
than
AJ is.
Definitely is. I give Kelly a whole lot of credit for what she's done, worked diligently to get what she is today, being Divas champion. But she's going to have a hell of a night come Night of Champions.
Some fight left in AJ. But how do you stop Beth? I mean, the Glamazon.
Whoa! That's that spice.
Whoa!
Wait a minute. This is it.
And will this be the fate of Kelly this Sunday at Night of Champions? The Glam Slam.
Oh, we do. We're going to have a new Divas champion. I can promise you that.
Tune up here tonight, yeah. Beth.
Impressive. Once again, Beth Phoenix.
This Sunday, Kelly, the clock's about to strike midnight because you and all of the other Cinderellas of the WWE are about to have a very unhappy ending to your little fairy tale.
Now, Beth Phoenix continues to put the Divas division on notice.